Let's do this for the fifth time. Hey guys, welcome or welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Fentola. If you don't know, now you know. Let's get into this video. So yeah, I'm going to be giving you, telling you actually how to stay progressive during this summer quarantine edition. You know, it's summer, we just want to flex, we just want to have fun with our friends, but at the same time, we have to do productive things, we have to stay on track. So I'm here to tell you all that today. So if this sounds like something you're interested in, keep on watching. But if you haven't done the necessaries, like this video if you like it already, leave a comment in the comment section down below, subscribe if you haven't subscribed, which is the most important thing, and also share with your friends and family. Now that you've done all that, you're welcome to give me love. Number one, waking up early. This sounds kind of cliche. Sis, if you want to have a productive day, you have to wake up early. You can't expect to wake up by 11 and still have a productive day, still do a lot of things, still accomplish a lot of things. That doesn't work. You can't wake up by 11 and you want to do this, you want to do that, you want to... Someone wakes up by 7 a.m., someone wakes up by 8 a.m. is probably going to be able to achieve more things. Probably they have online classes, they have chores to do, they will have time to do all that and still have more time to do other things, plus their personal thing. Waking up early has a lot to do with you being productive. And this is also, it goes in sync with you sleeping early. You can't sleep by 5 a.m. and expect to wake up by 8 a.m. It won't work that way. So you sleeping early goes a long way in you waking up early, which affects you being productive in that day. I know we all want to watch Netflix overnight. I'm on that day, Busha. We just want to watch Netflix overnight, chat with our friends, but we have to consider waking up early so we'll be able to achieve more things. So please, don't sleep by 12 a.m. Okay, can sleep by 12 or by 1. Just, you know what I mean? Just sleep early so you can wake up early. Number two, eat healthy. You don't want to wait, you don't want to come out of quarantine looking all... I'm not saying don't eat junks, eat junk, but don't just sit down on your bed all day eating chocolates, and that is so unhealthy, because like those fats are really unnecessary and they are unhealthy. So eat healthy, eat 3 times a day. You can eat like 4 times, but please, no more than 3 times. Eat in the appropriate portions and eat healthy food. Number three, making a list. This is so important. When I mean make a list, I mean schedule yourself, plan yourself. Like, I'm a YouTuber, so I have to film, I have to edit, I have my personal life, I have to join online classes. So I make a list, or I use my phone, a paper, get a pen, and write them down Monday to Sunday, what you want to do after filming, or what I do after filming. I want to eat, then I want to copy my notes, then I want to edit, or I want to do things. I don't have to cluster everything together and I'm much like, oh, I need to do this, I need to do that, I need to do that. It makes you more productive. And don't see it like you have to achieve more at a certain time. Make it that you want to be able to have less things to do. You don't want to achieve more things, you want to have less to do. Like, for example, don't say by the end of next week you want to have done so much amount of things. By the end of next week you want to have little things. Do you see what I did there? Keep up. You see what I did there? Because we are scared by numbers. Numbers scare us. But instead of saying you want to be able to achieve 10 things next week, or you want to be able to do 10 things next week, say that you want to have just 2 things to do next week. You want to have just 3 things to do next week. You are able to calm down, relax, because you are hearing 2. If you hear 10, you're like, 10, how am I going to achieve 10? Just like, do you understand? You have just little things to do. You want to be able to just have little things to do, instead of actually seeing a bigger picture that you actually have to achieve 10 things. But finding a new hobby. You need to find a new hobby. If you actually have things that you probably like doing before or something like that, perfect them. If you like cooking, if you like dancing, if you like singing, practice makes perfect. Perfect your cooking skills, perfect your dancing skills, learn new dance steps, practice them. If you like singing, try singing different songs. I just try new things. Or if you want to find a new hobby, there are tons of new things you could try. You could learn how to a new skill. Everything's online nowadays, so you can actually learn how to sew online. You could learn how to do a lot of things, learn a new language. And if you're thinking of starting a YouTube channel, this is the perfect time to start a YouTube channel. I started my YouTube channel during this quarantine and very fun to do, and you're going to love it. So if you want to start YouTube and you need like beginner friendly tips and tricks, let me know in the comment section. I'll be more than glad to do that for you guys. So find a new hobby, find something that you love doing and perfect it. Next thing, read a book. this is like, a lot of people, we don't like reading, like, but now reading has become easier. You don't have to actually pick up a book before you read something. You can do that through your phones. There are apps you can actually read books on. There's the popular Wattpad where you can get books for free, add them to your library, read at your convenience anytime you like. You can pick up a textbook, newspaper, read articles online, probably an article on how airplanes are made, how books were made, just any random thing. It's going a long way because readers are leaders. You read, you expand your vocabulary, you enter a whole new world, you discover new things. A book today and read. Next thing is revisiting your New Year resolutions. I'm sure we all had New Year resolutions we made at the beginning of this year. We plan to stop doing things, we plan to get this goal achieved, we plan to do this, but it's the 7th month of the year. Like, it's about time you revisit your New Year resolution, see how far you've gone in achieving this goal you set for yourself, see how far you've gone in, maybe you wanted to stop procrastinating, how well have you done with that, you wanted to read a book every month of the year, how much of that have you actually achieved. You will be surprised to see how much you've achieved, how much you've accomplished, maybe because you haven't actually been taking track of the things you have done, how much you can still achieve. If you haven't been reading the book you promised yourself to read every month of the year, it is fine. You still have like about five more months. You could pick up a book today and start reading. So tick off the things you need to tick off, how much of the things you have done. You could even still make more New Year resolutions, more things you want to accomplish. There's enough time, there's still plenty of time to do all those things. Be sure to see how much you've accomplished, how much you still can accomplish. Next thing, do some spring cleaning. I don't mean spring, it's not spring, it's summer, please don't come for me. But spring cleaning, like a term just used for like clearing up your space, bring out all your clothes, sort them out, maybe arrange your wardrobe, arrange your clothes, just like spice it up, jazz it up a bit. Maybe you can arrange your clothes based on how often you wear them, or by color or something. Just so many orphanage homes, you should be more than welcome to get your clothes, the ones you don't need, probably your old toys. I don't know why you're still using toys, but your old toys, your old books or something, things you don't need. This is the perfect time to clear out your space, decorate your room, decorate your books, arrange your, just like, you know what I mean. If you haven't still subscribed to my channel, what are you waiting for? Click the subscribe button and like this video. Thank you for doing that. Last but not the least, my last point, live life and have fun. I know we all want to be productive, but at the same time, live life, like take a chill pill, you know, find a new hobby, find something that you love doing and be good at it, and just be happy, because happiness is all that matters. I hope you guys enjoyed this video as much as I did making it. I hope you've taken one or two points as I end this video. If you haven't followed me on my socials, they'll be in the description box down below. I can't communicate with you guys on YouTube because YouTube doesn't allow me yet. But without, like, we can still work things out. Follow me on my Instagram and Twitter. They will be in the description box down below. You get to see the real me. You get to know me better. We can be friends. You get to participate in polls, fun stuff, questions, and things about my channel. They will be in the description box down below. Share the video with your friends, family, and your enemies, because I'll always tell you. But I won't leave you guys without my message for today, and this one is by Paul J. Mayer, and I quote, productivity is never an accident, it is a result of consistent excellence, intelligent planning, and focused efforts. I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye. Jeje, give me love, Jeje. I'll give you love, Jeje. Give me love, Jeje.